for your strength is made perfect when we're weak. When the road is long and heavy, when it's dark and darkened, see clearly.
It seems like life will never change, it's tide. But there's an answer to all of life cares.
Stay with God.
In spite of what you see or feel,
stay with God.
In spite of how things may appear,
stay.
I come to the end of myself. Yeah. Church, we're asking anyone with open tributes. Now is the time that we have the open tributes. We're asking anybody who has a selection, a word of condolence, whatever it is, to come now and let's start doing that now.
Me, you've proven yourself in my life.
Awaiting anyone with open tributes. Now is the time for open tributes.
Church, we're here to celebrate the life of an aunt, a mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, friend, and a very virtuous woman. My aunt loved the Lord, and even in her late days, the few days she had before her passing on, she continued to give God praise. And when you would ask her what she's doing, she always say, "I'm just here praising my God. What else there to do?" You know, and it should give us a sense of peace knowing that she has gone home to be with her Lord. The Word of God tells us, "Weeping may endure for the night, but joy cometh in the morning." Tears often fall on my face in sorrow, and as I walk on through the long lonely night, often I cry, but it seems no one hears me. Then to the shadows I can see the dawning of light. Oh, soon this old life, with all of its trials, will be left behind. There's a new day dawning. The shadows of sin will vanish forever. He promised me there's gonna be joy in the morning. Sorry. Hold on, my child. Joy comes in the morning. Weeping only lasts for the night. Hold on, my child. Joy comes in the morning. Oh, the darkest hour means dawn is just inside. Tears cannot stain the streets of, oh my goodness. Let me just do it. Tears cannot stain pathways of glory. No broken hearts we'll find up there. Beyond the skies, my mansion's awaiting. By light of the morning, we'll sing the song of sweet victory. Oh, soon this our life with all with all of its trials will be left behind. There's a new day at dawning. The shadows of sin will vanish forever. He promised me there's gonna be joy in the morning. Hallelujah. I like to apologize for my voice. It seems like every time I'm ready to go out, the heat and everything. So I do have sinus problem and you just shut my voice off. So I would like to apologize.
Good afternoon, church. My sister and I are here today to stand in for my mother, who was unable to come because she's doing what Herman and Merle have done, caretaking. She's taking care of her sister. But she sent her sympathy, her condolences, and most of all, her love. I didn't grow up around auntie, but mommy told us about her brothers and sisters and what was instilled in them by her mother, how she told them to take care of each other, be there for each other, and that goes on today still. Auntie lived to be 84 years old. So if there's any crying today, it should be tears of joy because she lived a life. Sometimes you hear people saying, we'll see you again. She's going to heaven, we'll see you again. In some cases, I doubt that. But in this one, I know where she's going. I know where she's going without a doubt. Because my mother kept us up on auntie and uncle and everybody else. She have raised beautiful daughters, beautiful sons who have gone on with good careers. So that shows a lot what our grandmother put in them. They continue to do it. As much as she wanted to be here today, she's taking care of Aunt Christy. But she sent her, again, she sent her love, her condolences, and her joy. And it reminded me of this, it was a play back in the days. It's songs, Don't Cry For Me, Vita. She didn't want Argentina to cry for her. So I'm saying auntie don't want Sinkins to cry for her. They want her to be happy for her, because we know she's gone over to a better place. Without a doubt in my heart, like I said, I didn't grow up around left in on 7, but my mother kept us talking about her brothers and sisters and how well her mother brought them up. And she wanted the same for us, and I seen auntie instill that in her kids. Marilyn Herman, y'all did a wonderful job of caretaking, a wonderful job. And I just want, once again, my mother send her love. Thank you.
Goodness of God. You're Good afternoon, church. I stand here with my mom as she pays tribute to a dear friend, a relationship that spans over 60 plus years. Jane was a caring, loving, humble, and dedicated individual who was always willing and ready to assist us in whatever the need was. On a number of occasions, while at the health center, I will ask her, Jane, you're going down by mama? And she would reply, Loretta, you know where I live. I'm going straight home when I'm finished here. Lo and behold, the direction she took after leaving the health center led her to Paris Estate by the same Loretta. This interaction would last about 2 to 3 hours. As she passes by the health center on her way home, I would say, Jane, you just going home? And she would say, keep out of me and Lawit business. Jane had a very sharp mouth, but she and my mom were inseparable. Jane was the aunt we did not have biologically, but for me personally, she was my second mother. During my hospital stay in 1990, she visited me quite often. The nurses thought that she was my mom and would often refer to her as Miss Hazel. They were shocked to learn that we were not connected biologically, as they saw a physical resemblance in both of us. Jane and Lawit had children that were born in the same year. Her daughter Jennifer and I attended the St. Peter's Primary School. Jennifer, on behalf of class 1975 of the St. Peter's Primary School, now the Dean Glassford Primary School, and the Hazel Brown family, we extend sincere condolences to you and your entire family. We also extend heartfelt sympathy to Debbie and Dolly Welch, my former classmates. May you find comfort and strength in this difficult time. May her soul rest in eternal peace. My mom, Her best friend will now do a tribute in song.
There's a holy and beautiful city where builder and ruler is God. John saw it ascending from heaven when Patmos in exile is trod. His high massive wall is of jasper. The city is there with pure gold. And when my friend head here is folded, my eyes shall it glory behold. In that bright city, soon coming down. No sin is allowed in that city, and nothing defiled nor mean. No pain and no sickness can enter. No grip is known. Oh, sorrow and care are forgotten. No tempest is there to announce. No parting word ever spoken. There is nothing to hurt and destroy. In that bright city, pearly bright city, I have a mansion, a harp, and a crown. Now soon coming down. No heartaches are known in that city. No tear even moisture the eye. There is no disappointment in heaven. No envy in the sky. The saints are all sanctified, holy. They live in sweet harmony, dear. My heart is thirsted on that city. city.
Distribute on behalf of my aunt Jane. This poem is entitled Remember Me. Don't remember me with sadness. Don't remember me with tears. Remember all the laughter we shared throughout the years. Now I am contented that my life was worthwhile. Knowing that I passed along the way, I made someone smile. When you are walking down the street and you got me on your mind, I'm walking in your footstep, only half a step behind. So please don't be unhappy just because I'm out of sight. Remember that I'm with you each morning, noon, and night. Thank you.
It's my only heart's desire. My only heart's desire.
For long. Walking with my grandma. Walking with my grandma. My grandma is like an angel. She takes you under her wings, prays and watches over you, and she'd give you anything. I used to like walking with my grandma. Her steps are short like mine. She doesn't say, "Now hurry up." She always took her time. I used to like walking with my grandma. Her eyes see things like mine do. Most people have to hurry. They do not take their time. I'm glad that God made my grandma unrusted and young like me. Now she is in heaven. Lord, please take good care of her for me.
Good afternoon, church. Thank you. My brother Fitzroy Bryant would not rest peacefully in his grave unless I stood up to express condolences on behalf of the family to Jane and her family. Jane worked with him for years, and we got on extremely well. Even when he was extremely sick, when he was dying, it was Jane who was there for him. And so today I just want to, on behalf of myself and our family, to express our condolences to Jane's family as she is laid to rest today. And so I thought that it would be remiss of me if I didn't come and publicly express our condolences to Jane's family. May her dear soul rest in eternal peace. I'm not afraid to be alone.
Church. This afternoon, we are here as members of the Water Services Department and, by extension, the Ministry of Public Infrastructure. We're here to pay our condolences to the family, and particularly on behalf of our colleague, Mr. Kurt Carty, who is the son of the deceased. Kurt has been an employee with the Water Services Department for, I think, well over 30 years. So we express our deepest condolences to the entire family, and we will be singing a song in tribute. Thank you.
Be with you. Please stand. Thank you. yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. I am sure that neither death, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. But to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and the living. We brought nothing into this world, and we take nothing out. Blessed be the name of the Lord."
In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we seek for help? But to you, O Lord, who by your sins are justly angered. Lord, you know the secrets of our hearts. Shut not your ears to our prayers, but spare us, O Lord. O worthy and eternal judge, do not let the bitter pains of death turn us away from you at our last hour. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, holy and most merciful Savior, have mercy upon us. We remain standing for the opening hymn, "Great is Thy Faithfulness."
Thank you.
Please be seated for the tributes. And the order of tributes will follow like this. First, Linnell Bliss. Second, St. Peter's Brotherhood of St. Andrews. Third, Dr. Terence Drew. Fourth, Althea Herbert. And then Mr. Doval Welch will do his tribute and then the eulogy.
Good afternoon. A virtuous woman. A virtuous woman. My grandmother loved Jesus with all her heart. Mom served God with all her heart, mind, and soul. She seeked his will for her life and followed his ways. She was a faithful bride, loved and respected her husband all the days of his life. She was trustworthy, and foremost, she was a bride of Christ. She was a loving mother to her children and grandchildren. They called her blessed. She taught her children the ways of her Father in heaven. She nurtured them with love of Christ, disciplined them with care and wisdom, and trained them in the way that they should grow. She took care of her physical, mental, and spiritual health. She cared for her body and prepared healthy food for her family. She served others with love and kindness. Mom served her husband, her family, her friends, and her neighbors with gentle, loving spirit. She was charitable. She was a wise steward of God, of the gifts of God given by her, by him. She spent her money wisely. She was careful to purchase quality items to her family needs. She was industrious and worked with willing hands. She sang praises to God and did not grumble while completing her task. She was a good manager of her home. She created an inviting atmosphere of warmth and love for her family and guests. She used hospitality to minister to those around her. She spent her time on that which is good and used her time wisely. She worked diligently to complete her task. She did not spend time dwelling on things that did not please the Lord. She was creative and embraced beauty and godliness. Mom had the inner beauty that only comes from Christ. She used her creativity and sense of style to create.
behalf of my aunt, Jane, one of the most sweetest, beautiful, kindest person you ever knew. Today, she has gone home to her reward. And I just want to admonish each and everyone in the house today. If you ever want to see my Aunt Jane again, you got to know Jesus Christ as your Savior. Amen. You have heard about him many times. Many ministers have preached about knowing Jesus Christ as your Savior. I trust that today will be the day that you will open your heart, ask Jesus Christ to come in, and ask him to save you. Because without the blood of Jesus Christ applied to our hearts, no man can see the Lord. Amen. So I encourage you today to trust him before time changes into eternity.
Amen.
There is coming a day when the heartache shall come, no more clouds in the skies, no more tears will dim the eye, all is peace forevermore on the happy golden shore. What a day, what a glorious day that will be. Oh, what a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see. When I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, and when he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land. What a day, what a glorious day that will be. There'll be no sorrow there, no more burdens to bear, no more sickness, no more pain, no more parting over there. Oh, and forever I will be with the one who died for me. Oh, what a day, a glorious day that will be. Oh, what a day that will be. Oh, when my Jesus I shall see. Oh, when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, and when he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land. Oh, what a day, what a glorious day that will be.
Good afternoon, church.
Afternoon.
Just permit me a few minutes to say a few words on the passing of Mrs. Cathy, better known as Jane. I want to start by extending my condolences to her family, her immediate family, which include her children, her grandchildren, her great-grand, her friends, and the wider community of St. Peter's. I've known Jane, as she's affectionately called, or Mrs. Cathy, as I would call her, for many, many years, maybe my whole life. But I had the opportunity to get to know her even better when I served as a doctor as well. And it gave me an insight that others wouldn't have. A deeper insight as to the type of person she was. And I can say sincerely that your first impression of her is exactly who she is. No pretense at all. She has deep faith, or she had a deep faith in her Creator. And she had a deep love for all, a type of love that is rare, but a type of love that we would all cherish when we encounter it. The love for her family was tremendous. But I would say that even for me, she would extend her deep love towards me. She would inquire about how I was doing when I think that I would be the one who would ask her how she was doing. She would give me words of encouragement because she understood very well the challenges of my careers. And I think she would have had direct contact with persons who would have been in the same field. And so her words of encouragement, her smiling face, her visits with me, her appreciation for what she received, were always a blessing. And so today, it gave me immense gratitude to have the opportunity given to me by the family to express exactly how I felt and how her relationship with me impacted me positively. I would like to say to them that she is gone, but she has left a tremendous legacy. And if we were to just apply 10% of the love that she extends to those who are around us, we will have a better community. And so I say, finally, you are gone now, Mrs. Tati, Jane, as we know you as, but we know you'll rest in forever peace because you were a loving and peaceful woman, an example to all of us. Amen. Rest in peace, my patient, my friend, and my grandmother. Thank Amen. You very much.
Thank you.
Good afternoon again, church. Today, we are here to bid farewell to an amazing woman. Mistress Muriel Delina Catt. She will be remembered by many as Jane Welch. To me, she will forever be Sister Jane. Sister Jane was born on the 8th of September 1937 to Cyril and Evelina Welch. She was the sixth of 12 siblings. On attaining the age to attend school, her school life started and ended at the St. Peter's Anglican Church Hall, known at that time as St. Peter's School. She then had to join the workforce, which at that time, based on your level of education, was either in the cane field or to work as a domestic servant. Fortunately for her, like her elder sisters, she was an excellent cook, having been taught by one of the best, our mother. Throughout her lifetime, she worked at many such jobs. Her last was with the late Fitzroy Bryant, whom she worked with for many years until his death, after which she found employment at National Bank, making errands for the staff, as well as taking care of their children after school until they were finished working. She worked there until her retirement. She was married to the late Stanley Carter, who was called to the Great Beyond 2 years ago, March 27th, to be exact. She was blessed with 8 children. Unfortunately, her first daughter died tragically several years ago. Sister Jane was a dedicated friend to many, but none more so than Mistress Loretta Brown. They shared a special bond. She would always remind us that she and Loretta had been friends for more than 60 years. She was also a very close friend of Kathleen Wilson. Sister Jane was the person who would always be ready and willing to assist anyone in the community who was sick and needed a helping hand, if it was only to sit and talk with that person, in addition to helping out where and however she could. Sister Jane was a very staunch supporter of the Saints' Needs Labour Party. In her earlier days, she would always provide necessary support for whatever activity the party was having. Sister Jane loved life. She lived an exemplary life. Being an example for her children and others to follow, she lived a life of prayer. She prayed daily without letting up. She was always calling on God, no matter what the situation. God was always her refuge. A few years ago, she began ailing. And as she got progressively worse, she had to be cared for by her children. About 2 days before her death, she remarked to one of her daughters, "I am tired. Can't hold on longer." She was lifted up in glory on 19th March by a host of rejoicing angels. In another time, in a happier place, we'll meet again, Sister Jane. Rest in everlasting peace. Amen.
Almighty God, we remember before you today your servant Muriel, and we pray that having opened to her the gates of larger life, you will receive her more and more into your joyful service, that with all who have served you in the past, she may share in the victory of Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Today, I'll be reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 25, verses 6 to 9. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, a rich food filled with marrow, a well-aged wine strained clear. And he will destroy on his mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all our faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, "Lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is our Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation." Amen. Here ends the reading.
Thanks be to God.
Please remain seated as the senior choir will sing for us Psalm 90, verse 1 to 10.
Thank you.
We sang the senior choir and remain seated for the second reading, taken from 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 3 to 8.
A reading from the book of 2 Timothy chapter 4. Verses 3 to 8. For the time is coming when people will not put up with sound doctrine, but having itching ears, they will accumulate for themselves teachers to suit their own desires, and will turn away from listening to the truth and wander away to myths. As for you, always be sober, endure suffering, do the work of an evangelist, carry out your ministry fully. As for me, I am already being poured out as libation, and the time for my departure has come. I have fought a good fight, and I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give you on that day. And not only to me, but also to have longed for his appearing. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you very much, Senior Choir. This afternoon, let me begin this short address by expressing to the family of our departed sister, Muriel, Helen, or Jean, as she was known, our deepest sympathies and condolences to you as you mourn the loss of your loved one. I am told that when she was able to, she was a faithful member of this church. And as you heard Mr. Welch said earlier, she was a praying woman. And so this afternoon we are here to celebrate her life and to thank God for her time here with us. And we pray that God will have mercy on her soul. We also want to encourage the family members to love and support each other and to look to God for strength during these difficult times. And so today I share with you a few thoughts from the second reading which we heard from Paul's second letter to Timothy chapter 4 and verse 7 and 8 goes like this. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From no one there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give to me on that day. And so I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts may be acceptable in thy sight. O God, who art our strength and our redeemer. Amen. A man was busy making all the necessary preparations for the day of his funeral. And he made certain that he chose the hymns, the scripture readings, and even the persons to do each of those. He even chose the color of his coffin. And while he was busy making all the necessary preparations, someone said to him, I see that you've been busy preparing for your departure. But have you prepared to meet your maker? And the person who was doing all the preparations, he had not considered that. And the other person was able to say to him, well, all that preparation is good, but the most important thing is not what happens at your funeral, but what happens when you meet God face to face. And so you need to prepare to meet God. Amen. And he repented of his sins, accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior. And we believe that when he departed this life, he went to be with his God. Sisters and brothers, many people see death as a failure, an end which they may even consider to be unfortunate. And we can understand whenever we lose a loved one that our hearts break. We experience great pains and we grieve. So much so that persons have been grieving for weeks and months and years because we don't like to lose our loved ones. And we see death simply in terms of departing, failure. But when we study Paul's second letter to Timothy chapter 4, we recognize that for Christians, death is not the end. And death is not something to be afraid of. Death is something for us as Christians to even look forward to. I mean, I know life is sweet, mind you. And we claim that we want to go to heaven, but we really don't want to die, do we? But the truth is, for Christians, we can actually look forward to our departure. Because when we leave this life, we are going to be with Jesus, and that is far better. Those of us who remain in this world, we have to experience pain, suffering, sickness, afflictions, disappointments. But when we get to heaven, if we get there, these things will be no more. And if our dear sister Helen or Mary, sorry, Jane, as she was affectionately known, if she remained faithful to God, then she's in a far better place than any of us could ever be. Because we have to continue the struggle, the fighting. We have to continue fighting the good fight. We must keep the faith so that we can indeed receive that crown of righteousness that the Lord has, not just for Peter or Paul, not just for Helen, but for all of us who long for his appearing. All of us who are fighting against sin, all of us who are following in the footsteps of Jesus, though we are not perfected in this life, but we can say thanks be to God who gives us the victory through Jesus Christ, our Lord. St. Paul says, I fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. When our turn comes to leave this world, can we truly and honestly say the same things? That we have fought the good fight? That we have kept our faith in Jesus? That we have finished the race? You see, in life, it is so easy to start and to start out well, but much more difficult to finish and finish well. We know from sports and even from our everyday activities that there are many persons who start out well, even in the Christian life. You know, new believers, they're full of excitement. They all can't wait to share the good news. But then as time goes on, some of us, we fade. We begin to trust in ourselves rather than trust in Jesus. And so we begin to fade and lose hope. And blessed St. Paul, though he had achieved much and though he was responsible for forming so many churches, though he had achieved far more than most of us would ever achieve, and although he was beaten, persecuted, and faced certain death in prison, he could still confidently look forward to his departure. Because he knew that though he was not rewarded in this life, when he got to heaven, he would be rewarded by his Lord. And that is so much better. In this life, we often have to say goodbye to our nearest and dearest. We often have to say, so long, see you. But the good news is that if our believing loved ones served God faithfully, and if we do the same, when we depart this life, it will be a great reunion. Oh, what a day, glorious day that will be. But we not only meet our believing loved ones who have gone on before, but we get to be with Jesus. We get to see him face to face. And we get to experience life in all its fullness. We are told in Revelation that in heaven there will be no more pain, no more sorrow, no more sickness, no more grief, not even death. Because God himself will wipe away all the tears from our eyes. And so this afternoon, sisters and brothers, I ask you, are you ready to go? Not go to the bathroom. Not go to meet a friend. But are you ready? Is your life committed to Jesus' care? If God was to call you home today, will you have the same confidence that St. Paul's had, that you're going to receive a crown of righteousness? Or are we not sure? This afternoon, we have the opportunity, those of us who are still alive, we have the opportunity to prepare to meet our God. Don't worry about what kind of service you will have when you die. Don't worry who will read the eulogy. Don't worry about who the preacher is going to be. But spend your time preparing to meet Jesus.
Amen.
Is your life a preparation to meet your God? If the answer is no, then you need to do something about it. Today, now, this very moment, we are told that now is the accepted time. Now is the day of salvation. Many, many moons ago, when I was a young boy, we thought that only old people used to die. And in fact, we would also think that, man, we have lots of time ahead. We could do whatever we feel like. And then just before we die, we make things right with God. But recent times have shown us that not just older folks, but middle-aged and young people are dying. And people are going to bed and not waking up. People are going to see the doctor and receive news that they have a very short time left to live. I'm not talking about accidents. Life is unpredictable. Life is uncertain. And we all know the old adage, tomorrow is promised to no one. So let us use the time we have now to make things right with God. Let us repent of our sins and ask God to forgive us. And with his help, let us make all the effort and strive and fight and remain faithful to God. Because you see, God does not really want us or need us to live a long life. Our sister was blessed with her 70. God does not necessarily ask us to be fruitful, but he wants us to be faithful. He wants us to trust and serve him faithfully to the end of our lives. And then and only then can we receive that crown of righteousness. But I remind us this afternoon that there could never be a crown without a cross. We have to take up our cross daily and follow Christ. We have to make sacrifices. We have to discipline ourselves. We have to pray and study God's word regularly. And we have to love one another as Christ loves us. So many of us, we claim to be Christians and we have little love in our hearts. We don't love our church members. We don't even love our own families. But God proved his love for us. And that while we were sinners, Christ died for us. And he wants us to reflect that love to those. How can we love God who we've never seen? And hate a brother or sister who we've not only seen, but we live with and we eat with. So we have to do our best with God's help, in the power of the Holy Spirit, to live a life of faithfulness to God. So that when our time comes to leave this world, whether today, tomorrow, next week, or next year, we can claim the blessed assurance that St. Paul's claimed in this passage. I have fought the good fight. I have kept the faith. I have finished the race. And we'll be confidently going to receive our crown of righteousness. That is, we will be with our God in heaven. We have no more sorrow, no more pain, no more sickness. But we will be with him forever. And that is far better than anything or any place in this sinful and dreadful world. So let us begin to serve God now and hold on until the end. Amen. And so as we continue our worship, let us stand and we confess our faith in God in the words of the Apostles' Creed. And I remind you that when we say we believe in one holy and Catholic Church, it is not the Roman Catholic, but Catholic meaning one universal church. So with the faith into which we were baptized, we say together, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son.
Suffered under the Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried.
Let us pray. We turn to page 2 in our order of service. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Blessed be God, our Father, the creator and preserver of all life. Blessed be Jesus Christ. Blessed be the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister Muriel Helen, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that her death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way, and may you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit through the ages of ages. Amen. Please be seated for the offertory hymns. First, we will sing Victory in Jesus, and if necessary, Precious Lord, Take My Heart. And please give generously as the Lord has blessed you. Thank you very much. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness and your loving kindness to us and to all people. We thank you that in your great love for us, you continue to bless us far beyond what we can ask, deserve, or imagine. And so we thank you. As a token of our appreciation, we give you back a small portion of what you have given to us. We pray that you may bless it, multiply it, and may it be used for the furtherance and the building up of your kingdom here on earth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Remain standing for the commendation as we say our farewell to our departed sister from the sanctuary. Give rest, O Christ, your servant Muriel Helen. Where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of human beings. And we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song of praise. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, in sorrow and pain and no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. And so let us commend our sister Muriel Helen to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant Muriel Helen, O sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set her free from every bond, that she may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, here with the Father and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. As our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend you our servant, we commend to you your servant, Muriel Helen. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. And as we make our way to the cemetery, please bow your heads for God's blessing. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, make you perfect in every good will, make you perfect in every way, doing his will, and work in you that which is well pleasing in his sight. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you, and all those you love and care for, this day and forevermore. Amen. The recession hymn, sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. Thank you.
going to ask you to be, please be quiet, please be quiet, please be quiet as we continue the service. We're not in the four walls of the church, but we're still worshiping. Please be respectful, reverent and quiet, please. We're about to begin this part of the service. Please, please be quiet.
Let us pray. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart therefore is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive our sins. And at our last hour, let us not fall away from you.
In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life, to our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Muriel Helen, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech in your infiniteness grace to live in your dear love, and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved son shall come again in judgment, our sister, Muriel Helen, and we ourselves will be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray.
O God, Almighty God, with whom still lives the spirit of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants, who having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we and all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, of perfect fulfillment and bliss, in your eternal and everlasting glory, to Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the death of sin to the life of when we depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the resurrection receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O most Father, through Jesus Christ, our Mediator and Redeemer. Amen.
Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved in the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come, with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Rest eternal grant to her, Lord, and let light to such a shine upon her. And may the Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon her and give her peace. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, the only wise God our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. We now turn to the hymns at the graveside.
And the first hymn at the graveside is when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be known.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be known. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning great eternal bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share. When his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. And when all of life is over and the work on earth is done, and the Lord has called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the world is called up yonder, when the world is called up yonder, when the world is fallen yonder, when the world is fallen yonder, let us labor, so let us labor for the Master from the dark to the setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Oh, then when all of life is over and the work on earth is done, and the world is fallen yonder, oh, when the world, oh, when the world is called up,
Christ in his blessed assurance, Jesus is mine.
Thank you.
presentable.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going.
Like a river attendeth my way, and sounds like city of you. some good morning when this life is over, I'll fire you. Thank you.
Today we want to give thanks to each and every one of you who has come out to support our family. And this shows me that we are a community of love. We are a community that's united. And we are a community that's strong. Hallelujah. Yes. Amen.
Can I have your attention, please? Again, we want to express our deepest sympathies to the Kathy Welch family. And we want to assure you of our prayerful support as you go to this field of mourning. And we invite you to look up to the hill, look to God, for it is there your help will come. And so may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful evening, everyone.